The fatal shooting incidents down south as polling precincts open for the village and youth council elections. Two people were killed in an attack in Butik, Llano del Sur. Speaking to ANC, Commission on Elections Chairman George Garcia said the suspects were already identified and a manhunt is underway.
We already have the suspects, and we already named the suspects, and the PNP is now in hot pursuit against these suspects. They are not candidates, they are just mere voters, but it would appear that the culprits are also voters or supporters of certain candidates.
Two people also died in a shooting incident in Maguindanao del Norte. Meanwhile, the COMELEC pilot tested an early voting scheme in Muntinlupa City and Naga for vulnerable sectors. Polling precincts in those areas open at 5 in the morning for the elderly, persons with disability, and pregnant women. But several delays were reported.
We would like to guarantee to everyone that these ballots were properly taken care of. I really appreciate the fact that our senior citizens woke up early, and especially even the PWD. We'd like to make a conclusion that indeed perhaps by 2025 onwards we should now have early voting hours during the conduct of our national and local elections. We're hoping that Congress will be able to pass an early voting law in which we are going to allow our senior citizens, PWDs and heavily pregnant women, including the IPs, to vote at least 1 week ahead of the scheduled election.
Go get an update now on the assessment of the Commission on Elections on the BSKE poll so far. We're going to get that from our correspondent, Victoria Tulad. Victoria, go ahead.
Carmina, Chairman George Garcia has been going around since 5 a.m. His last stop is the New Bilibid Prison, where 880 persons deprived of liberty, or PDLs, are allowed to vote. One qualification for voting is their cases should not have a final judgment yet. Garcia said allowing PDLs to vote is just as important as allowing others because they have their rights too. A total of 51,000 PDLs all over the country will go to the polls today. While some prison facilities provided spaces for the elections, some PDLs will be escorted to polling precincts if their number is not more than 50. Prior to going to Bilibid, Garcia checked Barangay Paliparan 3, Dasmariñas, Cavite, one of the three sites for automated elections. He confirmed that some vote counting machines did not work immediately, but said that members of the electoral board were able to fix this. Some persons with disability who are also voters here complained that they have been waiting for hours. A COMELEC official said these voters thought there was early voting in Cavite when it was only implemented in Muntinlupa City and Naga City, Camarines Sur. There was also a delay because the voters did not know their voting precincts. Early voting hours started at 5 a.m. and lasted until 7 a.m. Garcia visited the Muntinlupa Elementary School, which is one of the sites for this. He was pleased with the turnout. One voter who is a PWD and accompanied her 88-year-old mother-in-law said they preferred early voting to avoid the crowd. Carmina, in general, COMELEC Chairman George Garcia says that the elections is going smoothly except for a shooting incident in Maguindanao del Norte and another one in Llano del Norte. He hopes that the voter turnout will be around 70 to 75%. Carmina?
Thanks a lot. Our correspondent Victoria Tula there joining us on the line. President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. calls on Filipinos to participate in this year's village and youth council polls as he cast his vote earlier today in his hometown. Pia Gutierrez found this report.
President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. was among the first to cast his votes here at the Mariano Marcos Memorial Elementary School in his hometown in Batac, Ilocos Norte for the barangay elections. This year, the Philippine leader arrived in the school just a few minutes after the polling precincts opened. He was accompanied by his son, Ilocos Norte, Representative Sandro Marcos. The president then proceeded straight to polling precinct 36A, where he was listed as a voter number 70. It only took him a few minutes to cast his votes, after which he was able to grant the media a short interview. And in the interview, the president said that the government will continue to enforce all the laws against election violence as well as vote buying. This amid reports that vote buying is still rampant in many parts of the country. He says that government will not allow vote buying to be a part of the campaign. He says that even here in his hometown, Ilocos Norte, has been receiving reports that some candidates were still trying to buy people's votes, even on the eve of the elections itself.
There were some reports, even here in Ilocos Norte, na may mga umiikot na namimili ng boto para dito sa barangay election. Well, siyempre lahat ng yung mga kapulisan natin, yung mga COMELEC natin, ginagawa ang lahat para itigil na ganun. Pagka makatanggap kami ng report, pinapupuntahan ko kagad. Ang aking payo lang sa ating mga kababayan ay huwag nyo naman itatapon ang inyong karapatan na makapili ng mga inyong mga barangay official. Dahil alam nyo naman po na ang mga barangay official, ang mga kaharap ninyo araw-araw, ito ang mga tinatakbuhan ninyo para makatulong sa inyong mga problema. Kaya kung idadaan lang sa bayaran, ay hindi kayo mawawala yung boses ninyo.
The president also said that the results of the barangay elections is going to have a significant effect on the results of the midterm elections and subsequently in the national polls as well. This, as he noted, the influence that barangay officials have on their own constituents. Voting in the same precinct are members of the extended Marcos clan, including the president's own mother, Imelda Marcos, the former first lady, as well as Ilocos Norte Governor Matthew Joseph Marcos Manotoc and Vice Governor Cecilia Araneta Marcos.
Meanwhile, Vice President Sara Duterte cast her ballot in Davao City. Ernel Tocmano joins us to tell us more about that. Ernel, go ahead.
Carmina, as early as 6 in the morning, voters were already inside Daniel R. Aguinaldo National High School's premise to search for their clustered precincts, although there were several complaints since some cannot find their names in the voters' list. There were those dismayed and surprised to know that they were transferred to another polling precinct, even when every election day for years now, they are registered in the same precinct. Meanwhile, Vice President Sara Duterte arrived early at 8:52 in the morning to cast her vote. In a quick interview with the members of the media, she said that the Department of Education has set up a command center where the teachers who served in the election day can report any form of abuse, harassment, and threats and be supported with legal aid. She also said that they have not yet received any reports of harassments of teachers. Duterte urged the public to participate in the Barangay and Sangguniang Kabataan elections. Her father, former President Rodrigo Duterte, is also expected to vote anytime today in this same polling precinct. And that's the latest here in Davao. Ernel Tocmo, ABS-CBN News.
Joining us on the line. Issues in the voting process raised by the elderly and persons with disabilities at the Bagong Silangan Elementary School in Quezon City. Let's get more details now from Zian Ambrosio. She joins us on the line. Zian, what more can you tell us?
Carmina, more than 36,000 voters are expected to vote here in Bagong Silangan Elementary School. This precinct has the largest number of voters, one of the largest number of voters in the whole Quezon City. Because of the big population of voters, each executive board member or EB handles four precincts or 1:4 precincts, unlike before where the ratio used to be 1:1. A senior citizen was complaining to the news team, saying they have been waiting for already an hour to vote. One of the issues raised by some senior citizens and PWD voters is the location of their polling precinct. Those who are still able would walk all the way to the third floor to cast their votes. But those who are no longer capable were allowed to vote in the ground floor, sign a waiver allowing the EB to bring the ballot to the third floor precinct where the ballot box is located. The EB will be accompanied by a poll watcher to ensure the ballot's safety. However, some senior citizens are hesitant due to trust issues, as they would rather drop the ballots themselves. Other senior citizen and PWD voters, meantime, requested that the EB should not let the ballots stay in their hands for a long time and wait for the other accumulated ballots to avoid discrepancy. As of now, almost half of the population have voted. The bulk of the voters arrived at around 10 in the morning. Then, as you can see behind me, there are some voters arriving and are expected to come at around 1 this afternoon. 1 onwards. As of now, there are also PPCRV personnel who are deployed here for an orderly election. And that's the latest here in Quezon City. Zian Ambrosio, ABS-CBN News.
Thanks a lot, Zian Ambrosio. They are joining us live. Over now to the polls in Negros Oriental, one of the provinces being closely guarded by authorities due to incidents of poll-related violence. Romeo Subaldo now joins us with the latest from there. Romeo, over to you. Go ahead.
Yes, Carmina, police personnel and soldiers were deployed in all polling precincts here in Negros Oriental. Three policemen and three soldiers can be seen at the entrance of each school assigned as polling precincts in Negros Oriental. This is the first time that soldiers have been deployed in schools for the elections. This after the whole province was placed under communal control due to intense political climate and after the death of former Governor Ruel Digamo. 2,950 policemen, soldiers, and members of the Philippine Coast Guard have been deployed in the whole province. As early as 6:30 in the morning, voters began to arrive here in Negros Oriental High School to check their precinct numbers. There is an assistance desk from the PPCRV and the faculty of the school providing information to voters. Everything is going smoothly except for common complaints from voters having a hard time finding their voting precincts, but this is being addressed by volunteers. Kamina, so far, Negros Oriental Comelec said there is no reported or there's no election-related violence reported here in the province of Negros Oriental. Kamina.
Thanks a lot. Romeo Subaldo there joining us live. We now turn our attention to the polls in the cities of Pasig, Mandaluyong, and San Juan. Our very own Willard Chang now joins us with details. Willard, what more can you tell us?
Carmina, voting in eastern parts of the metro went smoothly as voters did not encounter any major problem as of this noon. Lines were orderly as a number of voters went to polling centers early, wanting to get voting out of the way as early as possible to have time for their other chores. Volunteers in Manggahan Elementary School in Pasig, Highway Hills Integrated School in Mandaluyong, and Pinaglabanan Elementary School in San Juan are on hand to assist voters looking for their voting precincts. Assistance desks are being manned by PPCRV volunteers, and there were seats available for seniors waiting in line. Some first-time voters we met went together with friends to their polling center. At first, one SK voter in Mandaluyong did not find his name in the list of voters posted by the polling center's entrance, but managed to find it when he decided to check it out in his assigned clustered precinct. In San Juan, Mayor Francis Zamora cast his vote at Xavier School, sharing the news that voting in the city has been peaceful and orderly so far, and that there have been no violations or election offense reported thus far, including the liquor ban. Mayor Zamora urged voters to exercise their right to vote, emphasizing the importance of electing village leaders who will work for the interest of their constituents and help their towns and city hall carry out programs and projects.
Gamitin natin ang pagkakataon ito na pumili ng mga barangay officials na sa tingin natin ay makapaglilingkod na maayos, tapat, sapagkat lalong-lalo na po para sa akin bilang isang mayor, kinakailangan meron tayong mga barangay officials na talagang nagtatrabaho. Dahil anumang mga proyekto programa ng isang pamalangusod, napakahalaga talaga ng ating mga barangay officials ay gumagalaw sa kanya-kanyang mga lokalidad. At hindi po kaya ng City Hall mag-isa. Kinakailangan meron tayong mga barangay officials na gagawin ng mga tungkulin na mabuti upang kapakanan po ng bawat Pilipino at bawat sa naman.
After casting his vote, Mayor Zamora will continue to do his rounds to inspect the situation of the city for the rest of the day. Carmina, back to you.
Thanks a lot, Willard Chang. We're now going to get an update on the polls in the cities of Makati and Taguig. Robert Mano now joins us for that. Robert, over to you.
Carmina, some senior citizen voters in Embo Barangays in Taguig are disappointed. At Makati City Science High School, as early as 5 in the morning, senior citizens are already in line. Among them is Arsenio Cadimas Jr. He shared that they thought they were included in the early voting, so they lined up. They were allowed in by the guard, but it turns out they can only vote at 7 a.m. He complained that he had been waiting for 3 hours. He also refused to let the deputy sanitize his staff drop his ballot in the box. He personally went to his precinct to submit his ballot. The school principal, Dr. Felix Bunagan, explained that there was no instruction for the early voting and they are not part of the pilot test for early voting. That's why they stick to the 7 a.m. opening of voting centers. At Benigno Ninoy Aquino High School, senior citizens are also complaining about the long waiting time. They've been waiting for almost 3 hours at the emergency accessible polling precinct. They mentioned that even with fewer votes to cast, they had to wait longer in line compared to the national elections where the waiting time was only 30 minutes. The staff explained that they need to have senior citizens sign a consent form before they could go to the precinct and get their ballot, and then they had to go back upstairs to drop it in the ballot box. The Philippine National Police is on standby around the school, and the PPCRV is helping voters in their precinct numbers and has medical stations. So far, according to Taguig's election officer, Attorney Eli Aringay, no reported or untoward incidents so far in Embo barangays and the whole of Taguig. And that's the latest, Carmina.
Thanks a lot, Robert Mano. Power interruption hits polling precincts in Quezon City, where automated voting for the village and youth council polls is being pilot tested. Let's get an update from our correspondent, Andrea Taguines. Andrea, what happened?
Carmina, voting has since resumed at the two polling precincts here at the Pasong Tamo Elementary School in Quezon City, which experienced some electrical problems this morning. This is very important to take note of, especially since they are conducting automated elections here at the school as part of the Commission on Elections pilot testing program. According to the assessment of the school's electrician, the power source for the vote counting machines in both classrooms, which by the way were just next to each other, seemed to be the problem since the lights in the room stayed on and they did not see any issue with the breaker. In one of the affected classrooms, the electoral board chairperson was able to record the outages at exactly 9:54 4 a.m., then again at 10:08 a.m. and 10:11 a.m. So this also caused the vote counting machine to shut down thrice. The other classroom also experienced the outage 3 times. And to prevent another power interruption, the school's electrician advised the electoral board to plug the VCMs directly to the wall sockets and not to use extension cords. And most importantly, VCM technicians from COMELEC and even the electoral board chairpersons and the poll watchers in charge of the rooms assured those who voted earlier today that their votes were not deleted.
Dahil nga po hindi siya naka-direct sa outlet and possible na naging maluwag po yung sa kuryente natin, and ayun po, dinerecho na lang po para po tuloy-tuloy na po, wala na pong maging aberya.
Kung makikita po nila, andito pa rin po yung 39 votes for barangay and then 6 votes for SK. And voting is now open po ulit.
Nagkaroon na po kami ng electricity, so nag-start na po yung VCM. Good thing po is nandun pa rin po yung mga records, yung mga votes, pati po yung names namin na naka-input po dun sa VCM.
Carmina, aside from electrical issues, there have also been incidents of paper jams whenever voters would try to feed their ballots to the VCMs. But teachers in charge of the room say this is no cause for panic as these can be easily resolved, and they are also there to assist the voters in making sure that the ballots are fed properly into the machine. Other voters we spoke with this morning said the voting process in their respective precincts was quick and smooth, since they did not have to manually write down the names of their chosen candidates. Pasong Tamo Elementary School, where 32,000 people are expected to vote today, is just one of 3 polling centers in Quezon City that was chosen to conduct automated elections. That also means quicker canvassing of votes. The COMELEC expects to get the results for the elections in these areas in just an hour after the polling precincts close at 3 p.m. While the queues for voting have been orderly, as you can see behind me, there's still a bit of crowding at the voters' assistance desk of the PPCRV, as many of the voters who come here still do not know what their precinct number is, and they don't know, they're not sure what room that corresponds to. So one tip that the PPCRV and even the COMELEC suggests is to check the COMELEC precinct finder online so that when they come here, they already have an idea of where to go. Carmina.
Thanks a lot. Andrea Taguines there joining us live. An election watchdog says there are warning signs that suggest failures in this year's Village and Youth Council polls. Contradaya notes, while it's still too early for any conclusions, the rise in election-related violence is already alarming.
I think we will have to wait and see for the COMELEC's pronouncement. However, there are still a fair warning signs, right, that there might be failure of elections. Of course, not just the instances of electoral violence, but also instances of, you know, a lack of even candidates being run because of course, of the threats levied against certain candidates. Or, of course, the number of instances, the number of incidents, those are seem to be racking up across the country.
Meanwhile, Contradaya supports the COMELEC's call for the continuation of the early voting scheme for the vulnerable sector.